Hello everyone, and welcome to another process injection video. I'm Cristina, and in this episode, we'll talk about another technique involving process hallowing. Previously, we've seen how this technique works, and we've actually used it to inject shellcode into other processes. In this episode, we'll go a step further and inject actual executables and use other legitimate processes as hosts for our payload. Let's start with this project, which is open source on GitHub. The source code and some binaries are included. Let's see how it works. The author already provides pre-compiled executables in case you don't have access to a C compiler. The payload displays a very simple hello world message box. The other executable performs the hallowing technique. See here. It will first start a process in suspended mode. This one, svchost.exe, which was initially suspended. After that, its memory sections have been replaced with the code from our payload program. This one over here, which just prints a message. If we close the message box window, svchost will terminate because it was just used as a host for our payload for demonstration purposes. So far, so good. Windows 10 introduced the Defender antivirus, which really changes the game in terms of detections. Let's see what happens. I'll copy both binaries over to a share folder, which is accessible from a Windows 10 virtual machine. This one over here. Here are the two binaries. I'll run the same binary that performs the process injection. But it cannot run. And there's a message. It says that it might contain a potentially unwanted software or virus. This is expected because this is an openly available executable, which Microsoft could easily find on GitHub and create signatures for it. Okay, let's go back to the project source code and see what can be done about this. I modified it to include a lot of error handling code to help with debugging. Very useful, especially for error-prone functions that deal with memory allocations. Instead of svchost, in this case, I'll use notepad.exe as a host process. Rebuild the solution and copy the binaries from the release folder into a location shared with the Windows 10 virtual machine. Let's see what happens. Also notice I'm compiling 32-bit versions of the project in release mode. Going back to this VM, let's see if we can now run the program without being detected. Awesome. In this case, it runs perfectly fine. It spawns the executed payload. The process tree shows that now the message box comes from the Notepad process. As expected, even though we specified the process name without its full path, Windows started the version from syswo64 folder, which is the 32-bit version of Notepad, not the 64-bit one. Cool, let's see what else we can learn here. So far, we've seen how to spawn a very simple payload binary using runpe technique. Let's see next how to create more meaningful payloads, like a reverse shell, for example. I've created this in Metasploit using this command over here. It creates a reverse TCP shell payload. It connects to this hard-coded IP address. The listener and the payload both run on the same box. For this payload, I have the binary form already over here. Let's make sure that it works first by itself. Start the listener on port 1337 and then execute the payload. It works as expected, and here's the reverse connection. Next, let's see if we can use this binary as the injected payload instead of the hello world that we've used before. We could recompile the code and change the payload name, or simply rename the reverse TCP payload to hello world. Start the listener again, and then the exe that performs the process hallowing. And that's great. Here's the expected reverse shell. Let's see also the process tree. Notepad process spawned this cmd.exe process, which is the reverse shell. Nice. Even after the program that started the shell terminates, the reverse shell is still active. That's great. Let's see how to make this trick work on a Windows 10 virtual machine. Again, start the Netcat listener on the same port 1337. As before, first test the reverse shell by itself. There's an error here. Maybe the program is still used in the other virtual machine. Let's check and terminate it if that's the case. Actually, it has already terminated. I'll copy it from the shared folder to the desktop and re-execute it. A functional reverse shell. So far, so good. Next, let's check if it works with the process hallowing technique. If everything will go as expected, this process will spawn Notepad, which in turn will get injected with the reverse shell. No fun just talking about secret reverse shells. Let's test. Great! It worked without any errors. In Process Explorer, here's the shell, started from Notepad. Notepad, a legitimate process digitally signed by Microsoft, as can be seen here, creating reverse shells. Okay, guys. One last thing to mention before wrapping up. The process uses the base address from the PE header of the program it will inject into. Here's how it obtains a pointer to the PEB process environment block. This address here, the image base address, is used to copy the sections from the payload into it. The image base address is just a recommended address, and the operating system doesn't guarantee that it will be this one every time. It might happen that Windows OS will load the process at a different base address than the one specified in the PEB. Keep this in mind. In such a case, we might run into some errors. Let's see if we can replicate one such corner case. go back to this virtual machine and reuse the original Hello World program. It should work fine most of the times. Although sometimes the OS might actually need to load it at a different base address. Tried it a few times, but seems to work fine. There is a way to have more control over the base address where a program will be loaded. Go to Settings, Linker, Advanced, and there's option to randomize the base address. There's also an option to specify a fixed base address. When using these options, the OS will attempt to use that address all the time. This is one of the caveats to have in mind if you're using this technique to load libraries or PE files inside other processes. To conclude, process hallowing is a useful technique to load and run stealth PE files inside other legitimate processes. With some considerations, it works really well on the latest Windows 10, even with Defender antivirus present. I hope you liked this video. Please leave your comments and suggestions. For more weekly reversing and deep dive videos, please subscribe to the channel. Thank you for your time. Cheers!